Everybody, my name is Dr. Sharon Munyaka, past president of SIOPSA 2023-2024, and I have submitted my abstract for conference 2024. I thought, let me have a conversation with you if you're still thinking about submitting an abstract, kind of holding it off because you are thinking I don't have enough info, or whatever it is that's holding you back. So let's get right into it. So for me, I looked at the conference theme, and for 2024, the SIOPSA theme is looking at mindful organizations, productive people, cultivating a culture of mental health. This is a space that I've been working in for a couple of years. So number one, I needed to look at, what am I going to submit? Am I going to submit a master tutorial? Am I going to be educating people? So what is it exactly that I want to be able to share during this conference? I also looked at whether I have any data that could fit into a research presentation. I also looked at the information that I have and looked at the abstract guidelines, which were helping me to choose where I want to fit in. So case studies is the other option that's available. And here I would be sharing, you know, practical insights of the work that I've done. A place where I feel I can contribute meaningfully in the work that I've been doing is in panel discussions. So this was the first point of call for me to decide what kind of abstract type do I want to submit. For me, the first challenge was around having the correct information for submission. So having the abstract guidelines has been a lifesaver for me because I use the abstract guidelines as a rubric. So number one, I looked at the abstract types that are there. I looked at the explanation on the conference theme. So am I looking at the landscape? Where is mental health, you know, happening within the world of work? What are some of the trends? I looked at the content. So what are some of the things that are happening in organizations around engagement, around resilience, and looking at how we promote mental health? Looking at that, I quickly realized that I don't have the requirements for some of the abstract types. And that helped me to solve that challenge of whether I have enough information for submission of an abstract. Deadline, 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 people. You need to take a look at when the due date is on. When I looked at the due date, and now it's been shifted, thank you, SIOPSA, to the 15th of March, 2024, I was thankful for the extra time that we were given. So looking at the deadline helps because when I submit on time, I get a chance to have my abstract included in the process. It's also important to make sure I align with the guidelines. So for example, whatever I'm submitting has not been submitted elsewhere. Whatever I'm submitting is true, don't make stuff up. Whatever I'm submitting actually contributes to the conference theme. So for me, that's really crucial in putting together an abstract that will be considered for conference. Just go ahead and do it. I know it can be quite daunting. And the beautiful thing is there is a community of people who are available to assist. So make use of that abstract email address that's available on the guideline to help you to connect with people who can help you write, people who can help you think through the topic, and any questions that you might have that are going to be challenging for you in doing the abstract submission. Thing by DJ Kent. Woo! I'm always ready to move.